Listen.
We bring to you another edition of Teams Agenda this week, a special report that focuses on the activities and achievements of the Teams Agenda of Lagos State Governor, 68 in its series. Youth and social development are like two peas in a pod, and many nations across the world have come to recognize the importance of these key sectors to nation building, revenue generation, economic development, and overall growth of any given nation. Hence, they from time to time deploy measures to ensure that youth and social development remain of topmost priority. In Lagos State, the administration of Governor Babajide Sanwo-Olu is youth-friendly and inclusive and has embarked on the implementation of a series of youth engagements and empowerment activities and programs through various ministries, departments and agencies, MDAs. This week on Teams Agenda This Week, Adewale Olowoporoku of our News and Current Affairs Department examines the activities and achievements of the Lagos State Ministry of Youth and Social Development in line with the Teams Agenda of Governor Babajide Sanwo-Olu. Youth can be said to be a period between childhood and adult age. People within this age range are often seen as a major force in building a greater and sustainable Lagos, as well as a better future for the nation, because they have the potential and capacity to make change happen for themselves, their communities, and for the rest of the world. On the other hand, social development is about improving the well-being of every individual and the society to enable them to reach their full potential. It requires the removal of barriers so that all citizens can journey towards their dreams with confidence and dignity. The Lagos State Ministry of Youth and Social Development is established to provide social development services that give succor to the vulnerable members of the society, such as children, youth, the elderly, and persons living with disability, PWDs. Under the present administration of Governor Babajide Sanwo-Olu, the ministry has taken various steps to engage youths and see to their well-being in the state. The ministry regularly conducts seminars on sexuality, reproductive health for youth and adolescents, effects of COVID-19 on the mental health and psychosocial well-being of youths. There were also trainings on digital marketing skills, empowerment programs, and even held a day mentoring program tagged Time Out with Youth Influencers in the state. All these were achieved despite the SARS protests and the global COVID-19 pandemic. In addition to this, Governor Babajide Sanwo-Olu on February 19 this year commissioned the newly constructed and remodeled Abesan Youth Center, which is equipped with counseling and vocational training rooms for catering, tailoring, shoemaking, ICT, hairdressing, a football pitch, and a basketball court. In the same vein, the following centers were equipped to make them more functional: Ojoniyi Youth Center, Isolo Youth Center, Lafiaji Youth Center, Akinwumi Youth Center, Wildi Ikeja, Ikorodu, Omituntun, Obele Oniwala, and Sam Shonibare's Youth Centers are currently under construction. Earlier in October, Lagos State Governor Babajide Sanwo-Olu promised to implement recommendations made at the Lagos Youth Symposium with the team Rebuilding for Greatness, Peaceful Conflict Resolution, where 150 youths had converged on Agidingbi Ikeja, geared towards enlightening the youths on how to employ peaceful ways of engaging the government.
What government should do and must continue to do is to create an environment where indeed the private sector, or indeed you can become an entrepreneur on your own, or you can become a solution to all of the problems that we have around the society.
On Monday, 1st November, in commemoration of the 2021 National Youth Day, the Sanwo-Olu administration stressed the importance of youth to building a greater, sustainable Lagos and the country at large. The day is set aside to celebrate Nigerian youth and the contributions they make, as well as highlighting issues affecting them with the aim of tackling these issues to support them. For the State Commissioner, Ministry of Youth and Social Development, Olusegun Daudu, the administration of Governor Babajide Sanwo-Olu will not relent in ensuring that the youth-oriented programs and policies initiated in line with the team's agenda are fully implemented. Other areas where tremendous efforts have been made in this year alone include capacity building programs, transformational leadership training, Ibile Youth Academy, Lagos Youth Symposium, and Police Youth Dialogue, coupled with programs undertaken by other ministries, departments, and agencies of the state government. The Commissioner for Youth and Social Development, Olusegun Daudu, hinted that government is determined to groom a self-dependent, self-reliant and business-oriented crop of youths to curb unemployment, and that the establishment of modern youth centers across the state is aimed at cultivating and enhancing young talents, noting that the ministry has been partnering with various ministries, departments and agencies like the Ministry of Wealth Creation and Employment, Agriculture, Tourism, Arts and Culture, and other non-governmental organizations to ensure that youths are gainfully employed. Daudu urged young people to seize the opportunity and key into the programs and policies that would help them acquire skills for self-employment.
Other youth programs that have been approved for this year include the Third Quarter and Valiability City of the Fourth Assembly and inauguration of the Fifth Assembly of the Lagos State Youth Parliament, the fourth edition of the Lagos State Leadership Initiative, which we tag the E-Learning Youth Academy. This initiative was came up for us to inculcate in the youth the virtue of citizenship, leadership, and volunteerism for the development of their personality, the society, the state, and by extension, the nation. Also, we have the biannual interactive session with registered voluntary youth and non-governmental organizations. These are voluntary youth organizations registered with the ministry. We have over 60 of them. And this is to encourage them to take part and come up with programs in their various areas, in their various communities. We have the Transformation Leadership Training Workshop for youth leaders engaging, and this is tagged engaging the youth in nation building. Well, this affords our youth an opportunity for them to be groomed as leaders of tomorrow. And of course, the Youth Mask Up program was Lagos campaign for COVID.
Children are as well not left out as the investments of Lagos State Government in the Children's Parliament as a forum set up for acquiring leadership skills while being prepared for parliamentary duties have paid off, as the current majority leader of the 6th National Children's Parliament, Toluwani Sule, is from Lagos State. The Child Development Department and the Ministry also provides adequate care and protection for vulnerable, abandoned, homeless, abused, or other children whose rights and privileges are stipulated by the Child's Rights Law 2007 have been infringed upon. One of such care programs is the training of members of the 6th Lagos State Children's Parliament on November 11, 2020. It is worthy to note that the Lagos State Children's Parliament is a veritable platform for developing the spirit of leadership and selfless service in children. Members sit quarterly to deliberate issues that concern them. It is a 3-year single tenure with membership open to children in schools whose ages range between 10 and 15 and is done by election. Other programs targeted at children include presentation of cash gifts to two families with quadruplets in the state as a way of supporting the families and making life more livable for their children. The ministry also handled 425 cases concerning children, with 163 boys and 262 girls on cases such as physical and sexual abuse, defilement, emotional abuse, child neglect and abandonment, children in need of shelter, child labor, lost plus found children, among others. It is also worthy to mention that 814 children underwent vocational training, transformation, behavioral modification, empowerment, and scholarships to higher institutions of learning, both local and international. Another 178 street children were reintegrated back into the society. Recently, the Lagos State Government constituted a joint task force, including the police, the Ministry of Youth and Social Development, as well as other stakeholders, to evacuate beggars, destitutes, orcas from the streets. To this end, over 1,000 people in these categories have been taken off the streets as part of efforts to bring sanity to the environment. Fits and areas where the ministry have also touched include school social work, which bridges the gap between families, communities and the school in matters that affect children. And under this project, 400 school children have been impacted. Family social service, which is a proactive approach to the preservation of family stability, which is the core of any society. Diversion community rehabilitation programs for children between age 10 and 17 who commit minor offenses or at risk of committing offenses. On matters related to the elderly, the present administration in the last 2 years offered services and care to about 95 from the newly renovated state-owned Old People's Home, Yaba. The ministry also handled 5,000 742 new cases under the medical social services through 27 general hospitals, health centers, maternal and child care centers, accident and emergency centers, counseling and testing between May 2020 and March 2021. Adoption and fostering processes were also handled with 239 applications were approved for the persons living with disability PWDs on December 30, 2020. Governor Sanwo-Olu invited various disabled groups, NGOs and other stakeholders to the Government House Marina, where lots of fundamental issues were raised and its approval granted. To also show inclusiveness, the governor gave out huge numbers of assistive mobility devices to the different clusters, and to show his solidarity, he, in February, appointed Adenike Oyetunde as SSA on Disability Affairs. The approval of free health insurance policy was granted for 2,500 indigent PWDs, and this means they will access 40,000 naira a year to care for their specific health challenges whenever they arise.
The achievement mentioned by the ministry wouldn't have been made possible without the support of Mr. Governor, Mr. Deputy Governor, as well as the determination and commitment of the staff of the ministry. In pursuit of the ministry creating an enabling environment that promotes youth and social development, our numerous activities have given support to vulnerable members of our society. However, we will continue to do more. I'd like to appreciate cooperation and support of negotiations and our donor agencies in tackling issues of social concern in the society.
Various beneficiaries of the ministry's training and programs spoke on how far the present administration has impacted on the youth and social development, and how much more needed to be done.
Some things that we are not exposed to, like the child protection law, it's not something I've ever heard of. So when I came into this academy, they instilled the fear, the discipline, everything that needs to build you up as a leader. It has been in us, it will never depart from us.
We are going to be coming out to advocate to see how proper waste management can be executed through the reuse of some of the waste items, the reduction of those items, and also through recycling. So as young people, we are going to put our hands and do the dirty work to make sure Lagos is better.
For me, on a personal note, it has really helped me in terms of internalizing the virtues of leadership, citizenship, and volunteerism.
It impacted a lot on my life because before, I had the glossophobia, and that's called the fear to speak in public. But now I can speak anywhere. I go to secondary schools to talk to them about teenage pregnancy and drug abuse.
It is with a great amount of confidence that one can say that the Babajide Sanwo-Olu's administration is a responsible one that does not only believe in planning, but also matching words with actions to achieve a greater and livable Lagos for all. The various youth programs and initiatives of the administration are part of the efforts to address issues bordering on youth development and empowerment in the entrepreneurial, agriculture, information technology, and leadership skills, among other facets of life. This brings us to the end of today's special report on TIMS Agenda this week, with focus on the activities and achievements of the Lagos State Ministry of Youth and Social Development in line with the TIMS Agenda of Governor Babajide Sanwo-Olu. For feedback, you can follow us on all our social media platforms: Instagram, Lagos Traffic Radio 961, Facebook, Lagos Traffic Radio 96.1 FM, on YouTube, subscribe to our channel, Traffic Radio 961. Also, you can now download our app, Lagos Traffic Radio 96.1 FM, from Play Store for more updates. This program is a production of Lagos Traffic Radio 96.1 FM. I am Abiola Fagbolagun.
Today's themes agenda this week focused on the activities and achievements of the Ministry of Youth and Social Development in line with the themes agenda of the Sanwo-Olu's administration. There will be a repeat broadcast just after the news at 9.
Not be small thing, no. You know what Junior tell me?
Testing. Hello, somebody. What's our problem, Gono? And what's the issue? You are inside motor. You shop corn. You throw it through the window. You are inside motor. You wind down. You are washing hand after chopping amala. What is the problem? Every time somebody wants to overtake, that is when you now give them bumper to bumper. You won't let them enter line. Why? Do they want to carry road from you? Ladies and gentlemen, let's be civil on the road. Be careful. Look out for other road users. Check your tires before you leave your house. Check your car. Make sure it's in good condition. And most importantly, know the traffic rules. Go to a proper driving school. Eh? Stop doing falafel on the road. Drive safely, Lagos. This is Frank Donga.
Obi, we summoned you because you have forgotten.